Well, it has been tough out there all day long. Not just tough, but downright dangerous to be caught out in this kind of weather. And I've got a time lapse of what we've been looking at since very early this morning in South Fargo. We had, of course, those big gusts of wind that brought our visibility down greatly and just continue to. And as we have moved on into the afternoon now, it's still troublesome, that wind here. And it's causing some issues once again here. In fact, we're still seeing 60-mile-per-hour wind gusts. Fargo is the place where it's happening, a gust now to 61 miles per hour. And check out that steady speed next to it, 46. That means that the speed is just overall continuously going about 46 miles per hour. Just some really gusty winds here in the valley, and it continues as we transition into the afternoon. The good news is that the snow has ended in Fargo, so the visibility not brought down as much as it was this morning, but we're still at a quarter of a mile in the FM area. And over where it is snowing still into Lakes Country, you can see we're low around the whole region. We're down to zero in Detroit Lakes. We've got a quarter mile in Fergus Falls, Elbow Lake and Wheaton, and back over to Park Rapids and Wadena as well, seeing that visibility quite low, a half mile or less. Up to the north, still getting blowing snow. We are down to a half mile in Hallock and Grand Forks out at the airport, a mile and a half. So this isn't done with us yet, even though the snow is ending up north and over to the west. You can see it's still snowing essentially from the Sisseton, Wheaton area, stretching northeastward from there through Elbow Lake. Fergus Falls right on the edge of that snow band at this point in time, but much of Otterton County is included in this, Wadena and up toward Park Rapids and Bemidji. Eventually, this moves east and we'll see that snow end. But again, that doesn't mean you're done. We're still talking about that wind lofting that snow and ground blizzard conditions continuing. It might get a little better in town, but in open country, we're still dealing with blizzard problems. In addition, the colder temperatures. We are down to below zero numbers up north. Grand Forks is at one below now, and it's only three above in Fargo. And this just continues to drop through the day today as that colder air continues to blast in, and factor in the wind, and we've got wind chills that are in that dangerous range, down as low as 30 below right now in Hallock, 28 below your wind chill in Grand Forks, and 23 below in Fargo. So wind chills that, if you're not properly dressed, frostbite can set in a matter of minutes. So I'm hoping that you've planned ahead and have bundled up and have loaded up your car with that winter survival kit if you must travel. It's best to just stay home today and let this system move out of here and quiet down eventually. It's going to take its time, though. Here's a look at the forecast for us this afternoon. We'll see that snow continue to move eastward. The wind will continue to blow. And as we head into tonight, well, it's still going, even around 5 o'clock. We're around zero at that point in time across the region. The snow is done in most areas, except for perhaps the Wadena area, back up to Park Rapids. And we're still dealing with some gusts causing some blowing snow. Later tonight, we'll eventually see that wind start to ease up, but we're still talking some gusts into the 40s, even into the late night hours here. So this is something that's going to be with us for some time. And in addition to that, the temperatures will continue to drop. So you factor that in, and we're looking at wind chills that will likely be down to 20 to 40 below by the time we get into tomorrow morning. And so it's going to be pretty brutal here to start off your Christmas Eve, 10 below your air temperature, but wind chills, again, even lower than that. And during the day, we're going to spend most of it below zero. We're going to try to climb on Thursday and heading into your Christmas Day. And Christmas Day does look decent compared to today and the rest of the days this week. We're looking at temperatures working their way back into the 20s.
I think anything looks better than today and tomorrow, or even feels better than what we've been through this morning. But, you know, I guess we'll just get through this now, and then better temperatures will come on the holidays, or expecting to. So that's a good sign. Thanks again, Lisa.